Well, thank you. I was really delighted to find out that I had won this award. The Anita Borg Institute has been near and dear to my heart for a very long time. 5 years ago, I was offered the job that I now have at NSF, and I wasn't really sure that I wanted to take it. I had a really nice life in Oregon and had really zero interest in moving to DC. But one day I was kind of mulling over what I should do about this, and I was driving across Oregon. Oregon's a really beautiful state. I was driving across Oregon thinking about moving to DC, and I was listening to Terry Gross, and she was talking to Mario Von Peebles, who was the son of Melvin Von Peebles, who was a very influential African-American filmmaker. And Mario mentioned that his dad didn't hire union crews for his films, because at the time, union films didn't have women or blacks or Jews on them. And he said of his dad that he didn't know, his dad knew that he couldn't change the whole world, but he thought he could change where he worked. So I heard that and I thought, whoa, I could go to NSF and I can change where I work. And I very grandiosely decided where I worked was the field of computing and that I would go to NSF and change that. So I went to NSF and I started the program called Broadening Participation. We call it affectionately, but not very imaginatively, BPC. And the goal of BPC is to get more students in general into computing, but we focus on the underrepresented groups, women, African Americans, Native Americans, and Indigenous people, Hispanics, and persons with disabilities. Together, these groups make up 70% of our population. And we need those people in computing. We need all of them. We need them because as a nation, we are really dangerously underproducing the number of undergraduate and graduate degrees that we need to keep a competitive IT workforce. We need them because without their talents and creativity, we'll miss opportunities for innovation. We may miss, as Bill Wolf has said, the most elegant solution, or we may miss the product that serves a broader customer base. And finally, we need them because as a just and equitable society, we can't afford to have the digital divide exacerbate what already is a very big economic divide in our country. IT innovation drives our economy. It promises to be the basis for many of the hoped-for advances in science and healthcare and environmental remediation, and it underlies our national security. Computing is a really exciting and incredibly empowering discipline. And as Karen Spark Jones says, it's too important to be left to men. In fact, it's too important to be left to any one selected part of our society. We really need to have everyone join in creating technology and determining where we're going to go with it. In order to diversify computing, BPC runs programs that target the entire academic pipeline from middle school through the junior faculty ranks. We run some really terrific programs. We have large alliances that run nationally or regionally. We're very proud to call NCWIT one of our alliances, although there have been many other supporters of NCWIT as well. We support the Grace Hopper Celebration for Women in Computing. We support the Tapia Celebration of Diversity in Computing. And we fund a lot of smaller projects that engage and support students around the country. President Obama on Monday challenged scientists to think about new and creative ways to engage young people in science and engineering. Well, my BPC PIs are way out in front on that one. So the BPC PIs are the principal investigators for my grants, and they've engaged students in incredibly creative ways. They have engaged them through applications of IT to journalism, to media, to art, to gaming, to cultural preservation. They've provided students with multidisciplinary and multi-institutional research experiences. They've joined the students into larger communities through workshops, conferences, social networks, and community service projects. And they've provided peer mentoring and step mentoring and faculty mentoring. And they've come together as a national group to leverage and scale each other's efforts. The people who are involved in this effort, my PIs, are terrific, and the very best part of my job has been getting to know them and to work with them. They're enthusiastic, they're committed, they're energetic, they're creative, they're really generous people, and I owe them a debt of gratitude for all they have done for BPC. Finally, as was mentioned in the film, BPC is just now beginning an ambitious new project where we're trying to completely change what's happening in high schools. We're going to start over with a clean slate. We're going to build a curriculum around a brand new AP course that we're developing in collaboration with the College Board. And it's going to be an inclusive, engaging, and rigorous course. It will be a target for the development of K-8 curriculum. It'll be an impetus to change college curriculum. And this new course will be ready, coming to a school near you in 2015. Or maybe not. So one of the reasons why it might not come to a school near you is that computer science isn't taught as an AP subject in very many schools right now. It's less than 2,000 schools, and there's about 23,000 high schools. So what about the rest? What about the schools in our low-income neighborhoods, like in LA, Atlanta, Chicago, Boston, DC? There's not a single AP computer science course in all of Oakland, for example. What about all of these schools, and what about all the kids in those schools? So for those schools, we are starting a project to, at the same time, 2015, that the AP course rolls out, we want to have 10,000 teachers ready to teach it in 10,000 schools. So this is a huge project. And we're going to have to get this to happen, work everywhere across the board. We're going to have to work on in-service teacher preparation for the teachers we already have. We're going to have to work on developing professional development services for them. We're going to have to work on pre-service education to create new teachers where we don't have them. We're going to have to work on gaining entree into the school systems, which is not nearly as easy as you might think. We're going to have to work on changing state certification and standards, which are a mishmash of really, in many cases, outdated and inappropriate things. But when we're done, we will have fixed high school computing across the nation. So I can see you realize this is something we need to do. It's very important. And this is exactly the right time to do this. We have a president now who's committed to science, education, and equity. He's right there with us. On Monday, he gave a great speech on science, and he said that America's young people will rise to the challenge if given the opportunity. And we need to give them that opportunity. For too long, we in the computing community have sat back and complained about too few students and too little participation. It's time for us to step into the fray. And so this talk is really about me asking for your help. We need to go out and change where we work. Thank you.